Well, there's some information about my own person on the homepage, so I'm not going to say much about myself. We don't have enough time. About 10 years ago, one of the eco-pioneers of Europe noticed that his very organic product was not sustainable at all, but caused collateral damage. Here we're talking about Gunter Pauli. He joined Ecovere in 1991, probably you know this company producing detergent. Within 3 years, he took over 5% world market share from Procter & Gamble and the other major players. And then when he came to see his suppliers in Indonesia, he noticed that the worldwide demand for palm oil, which was the raw material for his surfactants, he found out cutting down the rainforest and how to develop monocultures. Why does this happen? We do not have a systematic way of thinking. Business is extremely focused on profit and shareholder value. And in the business schools, the future managers all
darauf. Das heißt, wir haben eine doppelte Maximierungsstrategie in den Unternehmen. Das führt dann auch zu so
Nebeneffekten
der Finanzkrise,
die wir seit
2008 versuchen wieder
rückgängig zu machen und overcome ever since 2008 and nothing has changed after that crisis. But things can be done differently. Gunter Pauli then in 2009 introduced his concept, the Blue Economy, to the Club of Rome. And this concept is about a completely new model, business model, economic model, which is focused on nature as the biggest economist of our planet. There's no such thing as waste in nature. Have you ever seen a landfill created by nature itself? And there is no unemployment in nature. Nobody is superfluous, not needed. Raw materials cascade between the so-called kingdoms, algae, bacteria, animals, plants. Let's give one example. Who can tell me what is the second biggest product traded in the world? Think about it. What's the second most important merchandise? It's coffee.
Nach Erdöl.
After oil.
Wie viel Prozent davon landet tatsächlich in der Tasse?
What's the percentage of coffee that really ends up in our cups when we drink it?
0.2%. Wer das kompostiert zu Hause,
if you compost your
ganz massiv seine Würmer und
coffee residues, you put your worms and bugs under stress because coffee is a poison for the coffee industrial production are going.
Natürliche Lösung sind Pilze.
Right. That's also not sustainable. The natural solution are fungi. They love coffee. They build on coffee, they develop on coffee, and they degrade the coffee. And we do that in Colombia, in parts of Africa, in Mexico and Indonesia, and also in major cities where we collect coffee residues in Berlin, Munich, Hamburg, Kiel, Hannover, in London, in Hungary, in Spain. All kinds of cities and countries participate. What's the side effect of that?
Those
countries who deforest their forests because you need wood in order to produce fungi can't stop doing that. And we create simple jobs for normal people, not academically trained. We use the coffee grounds to grow worms. We can use them as fish feed, as animal feed, and as fertilizer. So it's a classical ecosystem. It's typical for nature. Nothing is done just for one purpose alone. Nature does everything for multiple purposes. So instead of a maximization strategy of the current big companies, we have multiple cash flows. And there's an optimization strategy where the different goals and targets are kept in a state of balance. What's the largest energy source in the world? Second example. It's not the sun. It's the
food.
The sun shines half the time.
Kennt jemand Piezoelektrizität? seit Jahrzehnten bekannt. Wenn Kristalle unter Druck stehen, sprich
when crystals are under pressure, they produce electricity. There are several companies in Asia at the moment cooperate with one another and develop
mehrere Tonnen je Stockwerk Gewicht vorhanden sind, dezentral Strom herstellt, um die komplette Gebäudeversorgung innerhalb des Gebäudes aus durch Piezoelektrizität möglich zu machen.
Used in order to create piezoelectricity. The bigger the building, the better, because buildings are moving. Like the earth is moving, our buildings are moving too. And it's also typical for nature. It's decentrally generated electricity, and you use the resources that are there anyway. How do rivers get clean? Through vortex. No river runs straight forward. They all meander. And also the air doesn't move from A to B in a straight line. It's always less energy consuming. Water that at the source is very dirty is clean at the end. Vortex can dissolve air and remove air from the water, so you can have either anaerobic or aerobic bacteria developing. This technology can be used to produce drinking water with just 5 bars of pressure. And you can do that on a worldwide scale. It's a module consisting of 5 stages.
And there are technologies
that make it possible to use the pressure in our water pipelines to generate electricity, so that the safety systems, the sprinklers, the emergency lighting can be fed with electricity just on the basis of this decentrally produced energy. And that solves a major problem that we have: batteries. 40 billion of batteries get thrown away every year. That's so typical for our production. First of all, we damage the environment in order to get the heavy metals out of the ground, and now we throw it away, all these heavy metals, and we cause more environmental damage, because mercury is not really a healthy thing.
That's
Homo sapiens. That's intelligent people. Nobody wants it, but everybody does it.
Ich nutze das Beispiel mal, um auch Blue Economy abzugrenzen.
And this is how Blue Economy is different from a Green Economy and other philosophies that you find out there. The classical Green Economy is about producing batteries with a longer lifetime. So we save a few batteries. Throw away a bit less. Have you ever heard about cradle to cradle? That's about recycling to make a new battery from an old one. Usually that is very costly. Blue economy replaces batteries by something completely different. I just gave you this example. All this emergency power system would no longer have to rely on batteries. And there are even bigger opportunities. Nature constantly produces electricity. Our heart beats due to electricity, temperature differential, pH differential, without a pacemaker. Fraunhofer, Germany, has developed mobile phones that, when they are on standby, use the temperature differential between ambient temperature and body temperature. And the sound waves generated are enough to generate the electricity used for this standby mode. Several computer manufacturers and Taiwanese manufacturers adapt that now to tablet PCs, notebooks, and that will be a revolution in microelectronics. We will need no batteries in the future anymore. Once again, nature produces always diversity. And that is why in our Blue Economy we develop business models that are culturally adjusted and adapted, because what works here would not necessarily work the same way in India or in Brazil. We always diversify income. Nature uses all the potential it has. And it also uses the potential of all human beings. And that is why it is important for us to create more jobs and not just replace the old industrial jobs. And usually nature doesn't poison itself.
Wir haben tausende solcher Innovationen
screened thousands of innovations, and every month we get several hundred new ideas. 2 to 3 are selected by us because they are really innovative and sustainable. But for us, it's always about implementation. It's not just an idea. In Bhutan, we just carry out 36 of these projects because Bhutan as a country has decided they want to have a sustainable economy and economic growth in line with their gross national happiness, as they define it. And it's in line with the Buddhist traditions of that country. On Friday, we had a press conference with Mr. von Weizsäcker, and we introduced to the press how can we opt out of nuclear energy without additional production costs. Nobody believed it first, but if you want to have more information, read our website blueeconomy.de. Every week we present one business model with the numbers and figures and ideas, and we hope to inspire many entrepreneurs, new startups, people who think about setting their own business. Hopefully they will select the projects that we can introduce, that we can present in order to use them. For us, ethics always is about accountability and responsibility. We shouldn't point our fingers to others. We should act ourselves. Manjiro Wanda said, some people dream to escape reality. Others dream to change reality forever. So it's up to us to change the world and redefine the economy. We just have to do it. Thank you.